This is your narrator speaking. It looks like Keith has an extensive health history. Specifically, he is having a rough time with his coronary artery disease and heart failure. Let's check in on Luke.
Okay, the vitals just came in. His heart rate is 88, his blood pressure is 158 over 94, his respiratory rate is 20, and his temperature is 36.2 degrees Celsius. His respiratory rate and blood pressure are high.
Yes, Luke, he is hypertensive and he's breathing fast. This could be a result of his heavy smoking habits over the years.
How's it looking over there, Han?
Well, Luke, looks like we're having some trouble getting inside the heart. Let's take a closer look and see what's happening outside in the cath lab.
Han, are you seeing what I'm seeing?
Yes, Luke. Cath report shows a 90% occlusion of the proximal and distal left anterior descending coronary artery, and a 70 to 80% occlusion of the distal right coronary artery.
I also see evidence of an old apical infarct. His heart ejection fraction is only 37%.
The heart is indeed having a lot of trouble pumping blood. This does not look good. This is way too blocked up. A stent alone is not going to work.
Later.
Poor Keith is looking pretty bad in his bed after his catheterization. Looks like his nurse is checking in on him. She seems to have found crackles bilaterally in his lungs and trace pitting edema in his feet and ankles and grade 3/6 systolic murmur at the cardiac apex. Yikes! Sounds like it's time to call for an S-bar.
Did someone call for an S-bar? It is I, your doctor. It looks like you need to be admitted immediately with coronary artery disease and heart failure.
Oh no! Are all of these issues caused by the catheterization?
Don't worry. All these newfound issues are not due to the procedure you just had, but we do need to get you into coronary artery bypass graft surgery to fix your heart's blood flow ASAP.
Han, did you hear that?
Not only is there an occlusion, but the labs aren't looking too good either.
Keith's BUN is 33 and his creatinine is 3.1. That's too high. That is definitely related to his chronic renal insufficiency.
His hematocrit is 25.3% and his hemoglobin is 8.8. Both of those are too low. I bet that's what leading to his anemia.
Remember, normally erythropoietin is made in the kidneys, and the bone marrow uses it to produce red blood cells. Keith's kidneys are really messed up and can't make the erythropoietin, leading to his chronic anemia. On top of this crappy situation, Keith is also in heart failure because oxygen cannot get to his vital tissues and organs, including his kidneys. In fact, Keith is now in acute kidney failure.
That's right, Chewy. His BNP is 1,021 and it's normally less than 300. Darth Vader has his heart working way too hard. His heart is failing.
Ah, finally, Keith is getting his coronary artery bypass graft that is going to make his blood flow fabulous.
We have come to kick your stormtrooper occluding factor butts out and build a graft in this heart. Luke is taking care of the intra-aortic balloon pump in the left femoral artery right now, assisted with a heparin infusion.
Why a heparin infusion?
The heparin infusion will decrease the ability for blood to clot, which is important to prevent complications after surgery.
Wait, Han Solo, a balloon pump? I thought he had an abdominal aortic aneurysm. Wouldn't the pump make it rupture and your heroic efforts would be for nothing because he would die?
Well, confused nursing student, it turns out the dark side took over the nurse who reported the abdominal aortic aneurysm. It was false reporting and the AAA never actually happened, so the balloon pump is totally fine.
Good catch, confused nursing student. The balloon pump will prevent further cardiogenic shock, heart failure, and help Keith's recovery from surgery, getting him back on the dance floor.
Balloon! Pump up the jam, pump it up, while your feet are stumping.
Balloon!
Pump it up a little more, get the party going on the dance floor. See, cause that's where the party's at, and you find out if you do that.
Balloon pump is in.
Finally, the occluding factors have been destroyed and the dark side has been stopped. for now. But the battle between light and dark is never over. For now, Keith is being diuresed with good old furosemide, a Lasix medication which will treat his fluid retention, heart failure, and kidney disease. His two units of packed red blood cells help stop his progression of anemia.
Looks like our job is done for now. Let's get out of here, boys.
And girl.
While Hans and Luke may be done for now, his nurses and doctors are still going to be hard at work monitoring his post-operative condition. Keith is still at risk for bleeding, acute kidney disease complications, cardiogenic shock, decreased brain perfusion, decreased cardiac output, and ultimately death. To prevent these terrible issues from occurring, his nurses and doctors will continue to work around the clock to monitor his hydration status, potassium levels, BNP levels, signs of nephrotoxicity, blood pressure, BUN, and creatinine levels, and his overall GFR. But the healthcare team and the light side refuse to let the dark side win.